हेलो लर्नर्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल श्रद्धास फिजिक्स। वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड अल्टरनेटिंग करंट सर्किट कंटेनिंग ओनली इंडक्टर, ओनली कैपेसिटर एंड ओनली रेजिस्टर। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर यू विल सी एन अल्टरनेटिंग करंट सर्किट कंटेनिंग इंडक्टर एंड ए कैपेसिटर, बोथ दैट इज इंडक्टर एज वेल एज द कैपेसिटर। नाउ लेट अस सी इन दिस डायग्राम, हियर इज द इंडक्टर, इट इज द इंडक्टर एंड दिस वन इज द रेजिस्टर in an alternating current circuit. Okay, this is inductor and this one is resistor. So let an alternating complex voltage at any instant t is v equal to v naught, v naught is the peak voltage, into exponential j omega t. This is the v equal to, the complex voltage is v equal to v naught exponential j omega t. So j, you know, j equal to minus 1 root over, or this is simply the iota in the complex number. So the physical voltage applied is V equal to the real part of V naught exponential j omega t. In place of exponential j omega t, you can write cos omega t plus j sin omega t. Now if you can separate these two terms, so the real part is will be V equal to V naught cos omega t. Okay, this is suppose equation 1. This is for the voltage. Now let us consider that I is the complex current and di by dt is the rate of change of this complex current at that instant. Now the potential difference across this resistor, here the circuit contains only the resistor and only the inductor and the resistor, both resistor and the inductor. So here the potential difference across this resistor will be equal to IR, because you know V equal to IR according to the Ohm's law. And the potential difference across the inductor, that will be equal to, this is also V equal to IR, but here in place of this reactance, since it contains the L, that is the inductance, so here we will write, in place of R, we will write j omega L. So here for the inductance, the potential difference will be equal to I equal to j omega L. So the sum of the potential difference across this resistance and the inductance, that will be equal to the EMF of the source at that instant. So here I can say that according to the KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, the potential difference across this inductance and across this resistor, that will be the sum of these two, will be equal to the EMF across this. So if I write VR, that is for the resistor, plus VL, that will be equal to total voltage V. So VR is the for IR resistance, and for the inductance this will be I into j omega L, that will be equal to V. That is equal to V. Now, taking iota common, taking this I common, this small I is the current. Taking common, this will be R plus j omega L, that is equal to V. And also we can write this I will be equal to V divided by R plus j omega L. Simply just remember j equal to minus 1 root over. And small I is the current here we have considered. And now this I equal to V by R plus j omega L. Now we know the Ohm's law states I equal to V by L. Now if I will compare these two, then our resistance equal to R plus j omega L. This R plus j omega L is the total resistance of this circuit, LR circuit. Or this can be denoted as, J into exponential I phi. So J into exponential I phi equal to R plus j omega L. And that is the complex impedance of the LR circuit. This Z into exponential I phi, that is equal to R plus j omega L. This is the complex impedance of the LR circuit. So the magnitude of this Z will be equal to R square plus omega square L square. Because you know the complex conjugate of this is exponential minus I phi. So if we'll take the exponential I phi modulus, this will be exponential I phi into exponential minus I phi. So this will becomes 1. So finally we can write the modulus of Z will be equal to R square plus omega square L square whole root over. And if phi is the phase angle by which Z, this impedance, leads the R, then tan phi equal to omega L divided by R. You can see in this diagram, this is your VR, voltage due to the resistance, and this is the voltage due to the inductance, and this is suppose the current is flowing through that circuit is suppose I. Now this, if it makes an angle phi, then it will represent, this is the Z, that is equal to r square plus omega square l square root of, because this side is nothing but omega l. This side is omega l, and this one we have considered, this is r. So the z will be equal to, since it is a perpendicular, here you have drawn a perpendicular to this axis. So this will be, according to the Pythagoras theorem, this will be r square plus omega square l square root over. Or we can write from this tan phi equal to, from this, the tan phi will be equal to omega l p by b, that is omega l divided by r. Or from the Pythagoras theorem, z equal to r square plus omega square l square root over. So simply it is written here, mod z equal to this much and tan phi equal to omega l by r. Now again, from this equation 2, you can see here, I equal to V by R plus J omega L. I equal to V by R plus J omega L. And also, this R plus J omega L equal to Z exponential I phi. And here, this R plus J omega L equal to Z exponential I phi. So, this I can be written as, in place of V, this is V naught exponential J omega T divided by this R plus J omega L is the Z exponential I phi, or here this is J phi. So this is equal to V naught by Z into exponential J whole into omega T minus phi. This is your Z exponential, let me write it here again. This will be Z exponential J phi, that is equal to R plus J omega L. Okay, this is the complex impedance. So by taking common, this will be V naught by Z exponential J, this omega T minus phi, this is the value phi. And if I'll put this I equal to Y naught, that is V naught by Z, this is the maximum value of the current, then I will be equal to the real part of I naught exponential J omega T minus phi. And if I'll split this exponential J omega T minus phi as cos omega T minus phi plus, this will be I naught into J sin omega T minus phi. J is equal to minus 1 root over, okay. And small I is the current. Now this I will be equal to, if I will take the real part, then this will be equal to I equal to I naught cos omega T minus phi. And again, you can see here, we know V equal to, we have calculated for the physical value, V equal to V naught cos omega T. And here the current will be equal to I naught cos omega t minus phi. So there is a phase difference of phi. You can see this is cos omega t minus phi. So in this diagram, if I plot voltage versus the time and this current versus the time, then this will represent, this one is the current, and this dotted one, it represents, this is your potential or the voltage difference, or this is the voltage. Okay. And this V equal to V naught cos omega t and I equal to I naught cos omega t minus phi. So from this expression, we conclude that in an alternating current circuit, that is LR circuit, alternating EMF will lead the alternating current by phase angle phi. Or you can say that in this case, you can see also I equal to I naught cos omega t minus phi. You can say that the current will lag behind the voltage by the angle phi, because this is omega t minus phi. So this value will be larger, the potential will, or the EMF will lead the current by the angle phi, or this current will lag behind the voltage by phi. So this is all for today. If you have any doubt, can ask me in the comment section. Thank you.